Arunachal is a backward state in case of education and in many other aspects. Various tribes of this state are still away from the light of education. Some tribes have the tradition of selling off the girl child when it is still in the womb. They borrow money, mithun, and other things from someone else on the pretext that if they have a baby girl, they would give the baby to him. But if the baby is born a boy, then they would have to return the money, mithun, and other property they had borrowed along with interest. But whenever any injustice takes place on the earth, God sends His messenger to save the world in various forms. She is an angel, Karunachali, who saves these victimized girls, who not only brings them to her shelter home, but also imparts them education, vocational education, and makes them self-sufficient. While doing this, she has to face various obstacles. The girls in the state also become victims of sexual assault, as a result of which they become mothers at an early age. But due to social obligations, they have to abandon their child. The angel Karunachali, who takes care of these children, is called Mommy, as she is the mother of so many such orphans.
हमारे ये स्कूल मम्मी जो है कि ये हम लोग सब बच्चों को हेल्प करते हैं। हमें जो जितना भी पढ़ने वाला बच्चा सब अनाथ बच्चा लोग हैं सब लोग थोड़ा अनाथ बच्चा हैं इसलिए मम्मी सबको हेल्प करते हैं। हम बहुत अच्छा लगता है मम्मी की।
मेरे मम्मी मुझे बहुत सपोर्ट करते हैं। वो ना होता तो मैं अभी तक वहाँ नहीं पढ़ सकता था। जी मैं आपको सब ये बताना चाहता हूँ कि मैं बहुत खुश हूँ वहाँ इधर भी बहुत खुश हूँ। मैं हर मैडम को बताना चाहता हूँ कि हर मैडम ने मेरा साथ दिया नहीं तो ये नहीं होता।
This iron-willed, determined and passionate lady with a vision and a tender heart for the poor and the destitute is none other than Binny Younger or Binny Maya, the popular face of Arunachal Pradesh among the common people. Endowed with such a strong will and determination and compassion for the poor, one can do wonders and bring a sea of change to the life of a person in particular and to the society in general. This is not a myth, but a reality. And this simple lady, with a long struggle of 33 years in the state of the rising sun, has proved this. An excellent teacher and a determined leader, a torchbearer of education for the poor and underprivileged, a crusader for the destitute women and children in the naturally beautiful and remote state of the country, Arunachal Pradesh.
তারপরে যারা জন্ম দিয়েছে মানে তাকে শরীরম বলেছে আগর জন্ম দেওয়া বেলো করে সব তো মরেছে এতো ডাক্তার নাই দণ্ডাই করি করি পূজা করি করি খতম হয়েছে ইচ্ছা তো এতো লাশ মানে যেনে তেনে ডাক্তার আই পাই গল বাঁচিছে
Her father was Binny Jai. He was a political assistant and a renowned social activist. She witnessed her father braving rigid social customs to show compassion towards the people who suffer because of them. When she was only four, she dared to show her love towards a couple of lovers who were victims of such rigid social customs. Being the daughter of a social activist, Binny from a very young age witnessed the destitute and helpless come to their home seeking for help.
एज ए सोशल वर्कर उनको अभी से मैं नहीं जान, बचपन से जब वनस्थली विद्यापीठ में पढ़ती थी तब से जब छुट्टी में जब वनस्थली से आती है तो जितना मैंने वहाँ के जो स्टूडेंट लोग का कपड़ा को लेके गरीब गरीब बच्चों को बांटती थी.
During 1962 to 1967, when Binny was a young girl, there was neither police nor a shelter home. One clan fought against the other, and the women became the worst victims. All such cases were settled in their house. Binny was a silent observer to all these, and she silently nurtured a dream to do something for the people.
मेरे पिताजी के साथ साथ मेरी दादी, मेरी माँ, सब लोग मेरे परिवार में सोशल वर्कर ही थे. मैं अपनी परिवार में तीसरी पीढ़ी में थी. मेरी माँ से पहले, मेरी पिताजी से पहले मेरी दादी भी उस ज़माने में अपने गांव की एक अच्छे सामाजिक कार्यकर्ता में से गिने जाते थे. मेरे दादी के परिवार बहुत ही अच्छे थे. उनकी शादी में बहुत सारी नौकर चाकर को दहेज के रूप में दिया था, मगर जैसे ही भारत स्वाधीन हुआ मेरी दादी ने उन सब को मुक्त कर दिया और उनके बदले में गवर्नमेंट से कुछ नहीं लिया. और वही उन्हीं लोगों में से एक बच्चा ने फर्स्ट हमारी समाज में बीए पास कर लिया.
Binny Yanga studied up to class 3 at Zero, Arunachal Pradesh. Then she was sent to Rajasthan. At that time, the Arunachal government selected some students to send them to Rajasthan for studying. Binny Yanga was one of them. She studied in Banasthali Vidyapith, Rajasthan for 6 years.
जैसे जैसे मैं बनस्थली से वापस आती थी अपनी छुट्टियों में, मेरे पिताजी मुझे हमेशा एनकरेज करते थे कि आप वहाँ जो भी सीख के आया है यहाँ पे सब बहनों को सब उनको सिखाओ. इस प्रकार मैं जैसे जैसे आई वहाँ पे एक सब लड़कियों को मिलके एक ऑल सुवर्णश्री गर्ल्स स्टूडेंट यूनियन के नाम से एक संस्था को मैंने खोला. और मेरे पिताजी ने बोला कि मुझे आप कभी अपने आप को लड़की मत समझो, आप हमेशा हर काम को स्वाभिमान के साथ साहस के साथ करो. इसलिए आज मैं जो कुछ भी हूँ मैं अपने पिताजी को श्रेय देना चाहूँगी. बिना पिताजी के छत्र छाया रह के मैं अगर कोई भी कार्य करते तो इतनी सफल नहीं होती जितना आज मैं इस मुकाम पे पहुँची हूँ.
Binny started her professional life in 1975 as an assistant teacher at Dokom Village Zero and served under Education Department, Government of Arunachal Pradesh.
मैं बहुत ही दूर में एक गांव दुकुम नाम के एक गांव में, वहां मैं अकेली टीचर थी और 4 क्लास को पढ़ाना पड़ते थे. फिर भी मैं अब भी सोचने से मुझे मैं ये सोचती हूं कि मैं सच में बहुत ही उस ज़माने में एक ही उदाहरण लायक काम करती थी. मैं अकेली टीचर होते हुए भी उन 4 क्लास को मैं बहुत ही कर्मबद्ध से अच्छी तरह से निभाती थी. क्लास 5 के बच्चों को मैं पढ़ाती थी, तो 4 के बच्चे 3 के बच्चों को पढ़ाते थे, 3 के बच्चे 2 के बच्चों को. इस प्रकार की हम लोगों ने बच्चों से ही क्लास को लेने दिया और बच्चे इसलिए बहुत उत्साहित रहते थे कि हाँ हम अपने से छोटों को भी पढ़ा पा रहे हैं. और बच्चों के साथ में इतनी घुल मिल जाती थी कि कभी कभी अपने आप को भूल जाती थी मैं टीचर हूँ.
She was one of the first ladies to join the first batch of lady police under Arunachal Pradesh in 1978.
जैसे ही मैंने एक बार ये एडवर्टाइजमेंट सुना है कि अरुणाचल प्रदेश में महिला पुलिस भी इंट्रोड्यूस करने जा रहे हैं, केवल उस समय 5 लड़कियों को लिया गया था, 5 डिस्ट्रिक्ट में, 1 डिस्ट्रिक्ट में 1 लड़की. घर पे सबको पूछा तो सबने परमिशन नहीं दिया कि नहीं आप नहीं जा सकते हैं. मैं घर से भाग के गई, जाके इंटरव्यू दिया. इंटरव्यू में मैं मेरिट लिस्ट में 1 नंबर में रही. इस प्रकार मैं अपनी ट्रेनिंग के दौरान भी मैं 1 नंबर में रही. शूटिंग में इंडोर जो भी हमारी लॉ की क्लास होते थे उसमें भी मैं 1 नंबर में रही. इस प्रकार मैं 7 साल पुलिस नौकरी किया.
While in the police service, Binny always carried a resignation letter in her pocket, and whenever she found her task difficult, she placed the letter to quit the job. But her seniors were really helpful. It was their support that encouraged Binny to serve Arunachal Police for 7 years. While working there, she saw the oppressed poor girls and women come seeking for help. And those who came seeking help were considered indecent girls or women by the society. Such attitude of the society brings more pain to their life. They were in such a pitiable condition that she could not but felt the need for setting up shelter homes and rehabilitation centers for these oppressed girls and women.
उस समय मेरे पास इतनी बड़ा पूंजी भी नहीं थी कि मैं किसी को आसानी से सहारा दे सकूं। फिर भी मैंने हिम्मत के साथ एक छोटी सी संस्था खोला जिसका नाम OU Welfare Association रखा।
Binny is not a lady who only dreams. She acts and turns her dreams into reality. In 1979, her dream came true when she started a small adult education and nursery center in Nahalogun. She also set up a small shelter home for girls and the victims of forced marriage and destitute women. It was the first major step she had taken towards the oppressed and destitute of the society. It functions for the empowerment of women and the welfare of children to achieve a holistic socio-economic and environmental development of communities in Arunachal Pradesh. Binny registered the small center to an NGO in 1988. The OU Welfare Association provides short stay home for 30 destitute women and financial aid to 80 students. The association also provides maintenance to 200 destitute children. It also has an ashram school for 150 primary students.
हम चौथा से मेरा माँ के साथ उसको हम शक्ल नहीं देखा है ना और मेरा पिताजी है और सोतेले माधोतु है ना और मेरा भाई नहीं है और भैया नहीं है दीदी नहीं है ना और हम अकेला है और उसका बाद चौथा में ऐसा आदमी का घर में हम बेटा है ना बेटने का बाद में हमको बड़ा होने का बाद ऐसा पाल के बड़ा होने का बाद में ना फिर दूसरा का घर में भेज दिया ना और किस लिए भेजा उसको मालूम नहीं है ना फिर वो आंटी जो बोलते हैं मेरा भी एक कारण है आपको ऐसा भेजने का ना तो वो क्या कारण है उसको हमको नहीं बताया किस लिए भेजा
शी इज अ पर्सन हु हैज सैक्रिफाइस्ड हर लाइफ फॉर द अंडर प्रिविलेज्ड एंड फॉर द चैलेंज्ड पीपल And I have been to her OU mission. I have been seeing her work. And I can only say that she is selfless and has been working without caring about her own self. She is herself fighting cancer. But what an inspiration she is for everybody that she has risen to the heights of, I would say, almost a supreme sacrifice.
Since I met Binny Yanga and I went to the OU mission, I think she is tremendous. She is doing such a great job. I mean, it's incomprehensible for one single lady to be doing so much.
Binny Yanga is like my sister. She started her career by serving people to a downtrodden, the vulnerable sections of the society, particularly those orphans, the destitutes and handicaps. She established schools and also home, and she cares, she loves those children. Along with her own children, she started the caring them.
তেওঁৰ বিষয়ে ক'লেতো গোটেই দিনো মানে শেষ নহ'ব তেখেতৰ বিষয়ে ক'বলৈ আজি মোৰ বন্ধু বুলি মই কোৱা নাই তেওঁৰ মানে খুব উৎসাহী আছিলে সৰুৰে পৰা তেওঁ কেতিয়াবা স্কুল দিনত তেওঁ কবিতাও লিখি ভাল পায় তেওঁ কাহিনীও লিখে শ্বৰ্ট ষ্টৰি লিখে
শ্বি হেজ বিকাম এন ইনষ্টিটিউশ্যন ইন হাৰচেল্ফ ফৰ মেনি মেনি ইয়ং গাৰ্লছ অফ অৰুণাচল প্ৰদেশ ইয়ং উইমেনছ অফ অৰুণাচল প্ৰদেশ এণ্ড স্পেচিয়েলি She is a symbolic of love, adorance, and care for weaker sections of the people, especially in the girl child.
The orphans studying in the residential school at Papun Pare is a very good example of her goodwill mission. Providing primary needs like food and shelter to the poor and destitute can be anyone's mission. But educating them and making them self-sufficient is really a difficult task. She is a cancer patient and has been suffering from this deadly disease for the last 7 years.
She was suggestive of some sort of a malignancy. And she has been on follow-up right now, and she is as sprightly as ever without any suggestion that she has a malignancy. And our current evaluation also suggests a low progress in the malignancy, but which does not, to our knowledge, require any intervention right now. She may require treatment at a later date, but till such time that she has no problems, we would want to keep her under observation, because our guidelines would say that giving more treatment at this point of time is not required. So we are keeping under observation, and after which we will monitor her. We know that we cannot possibly eradicate the disease, but we certainly are so far able to control the disease and allow Mrs. Binney to continue to do what she wants and what she loves and what she is so good at. Such a remarkable patient I have never had, and I don't think I will also have in the near future. So we all hope that everything goes well with Mrs. Binney, but then we are also reasonably prepared to see what we can do should she require any further intervention. Till such time, I wish her all the best, and I encourage her to do whatever she wants towards the betterment of the society, especially towards empowerment of women and fighting for their cause.
Neela neela tumar shok juri shok juri kola kola tumar sela uri sela uri moni uri kola sarai aru kola kuli.
As recognition for her 33 years old service towards the society, the government of India conferred on her the highest civilian award, the Padma Shri, in 2012.
Srimati Binney Yanga, Samaj Seva.
She is the one among the 6 people from the Northeast to receive this prestigious award. While receiving the award, she acknowledged that it was the outcome of her 33 years of arduous labor for the upliftment of the tribal society in Arunachal Pradesh. She also received the prestigious Durgabai Deshmukh Award in 2000. And the NCDC Corporate Excellence Award in 2002 for her hard work and devotion towards the needy and helpless. She has also received several other awards and recognition from Assam and several other states and the central government.
Award for outstanding services. Excellence Award for outstanding services.
Madam Binney Yanga is a pioneer in Arunachal Pradesh so far, social work is concerned. She is really concerned for the orphan, for the helpless women, and for these two class of people, she had struggled very much, and she, through her hard work, her dedication, had rendered human service for the benefit of these two classes of the people.
She is also associated with various state and national level organizations. She was also nominated as a member of the Steering Committee on Voluntary Sector Planning Commission. As a member, she has also been associated with various organizations, namely Voluntary Sector Planning Commission, Government of India, Executive Committee, National Literacy Mission Authority, Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India, Arunachal Pradesh State Commission for Women, Country Women Association of India, and various other organizations. Bini Mami, as all address her, is an iron-willed lady. She has even conquered death by postponing it. Thenceforth, she has been working at such a pace as if the world would stand still if she stopped working. She has so much to do for the oppressed and the destitute of the society. American poet Robert Frost, she feels, "The woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have promises to keep, and miles to go before I sleep, and miles to go before I sleep."